In many economic models, households are treated as a single decision-making unit. They receive income and make consumption, investment, and savings decisions. But in reality, most households are not unitary objects. They are formed of multiple people with their own objectives and motivations. Does this distinction matter? A common assumption is that even with many members, a household's decision-making is nonetheless efficient. That is, no household resources are wasted, and the household's decisions will align with those of a unitary entity behaving optimally. This paper tests that assumption. The authors study the efficiency of married couples' decisions when saving for retirement. Workers in the U.S. commonly have access to an employer-sponsored retirement saving plan that offers an employer match. For every dollar an employee contributes to their own retirement, their employer matches that contribution at a given rate. And because match schedules vary across employers, the financial incentives for saving can differ between two spouses' accounts. If one has a dollar-for-dollar employer match up to a cap, while the other has a 50 cents on the dollar match, then, at the household level, the efficient allocation is to funnel all contributions to the first spouse's account before making any contributions to the second spouse's account. More generally, spouses should allocate their savings so as to maximize the amount of employer match achieved at the household level. This is especially true as, in case of divorce, retirement assets in the U.S. are divided independently of who made the contributions. The question, then, is whether people's actual allocations align with these efficient benchmarks. To assess this, the authors combine extensive employer data on retirement plan characteristics with administrative tax records that link spouses together and track their annual retirement plan contributions. The data cover over a million individuals, and for each married couple, the authors calculate the level of foregone match. For a given level of savings, this is the amount by which the household's maximum possible employer match exceeds their actual one. Couples with positive foregone match are not allocating their savings efficiently. They could increase their joint retirement savings merely by reallocating savings from one spouse to the other. The headline result is that inefficiency abounds. To illustrate, consider a particular subset of the data for whom the efficient strategy is very simple. One spouse should do all the saving because their match rate is higher and the couple's total level of saving is below the employer's cap. This figure groups these couples according to the match rates available to each spouse. The efficient strategy is for the spouse with a higher match rate to do 100% of the saving, but what we actually see is that the proportion saved by the high match spouse ranges from just 55 to 86%. Correspondingly, while efficiency would imply that 0% of these couples should have positive foregone match, in reality, the proportion ranges from 24 to 59%. More broadly, across the full sample, nearly 20% of couples fails to allocate their savings efficiently, and this non-coordination is both costly and persistent. On average, these couples forego an additional $757 per year in employer matching contributions, and more than half of couples with an inefficient allocation in a given year are still allocating their savings inefficiently 4 years later. Simulations show that such non-coordination throughout the life cycle can lower wealth at retirement by an average of $14,000. Note, as well, that while 80% of couples in the data have no foregone match, this does not imply that they are actively coordinating. Couples may achieve household-level efficiency inadvertently, even while making independent savings decisions. And, indeed, several benchmarking exercises suggest that finding that 20% of couples have positive foregone match is consistent with a scenario in which the majority of couples do not actively coordinate their retirement savings. What drives this behavior? Are these unintended mistakes, or the results of deliberate decision-making? On one hand, there is no evidence for several common types of behavioral bias. Couples do not systematically improve efficiency when they make active savings decisions, which suggests inertia is not driving the results. And non-coordination is also insensitive to the stakes in question, which suggests that rational inattention is not driving the results. At the same time, additional survey data suggest that inattention of some variety is a contributing factor. When asked to make a hypothetical allocation between their retirement account and their spouse's, 40% of respondents fail to maximize their household-level employer match. Upon having this pointed out, roughly half choose to reallocate their contribution, indicating that the initial foregone match was accidental. This mistake appears to be driven by inattention to the fact that there might be financial gains from coordination, and, relatedly, respondents who score higher on measures of financial literacy are less likely to have any foregone match. For the remaining respondents, however, this foregone match appears to be deliberate. This may reflect, in part, a desire for control, especially in cases where marital commitment is relatively low. In the administrative data, non-coordination is higher among couples who subsequently divorce, and lower for those who hold a joint bank account before marrying. The survey data also reveal that many couples are unfamiliar or misinformed about the treatment of retirement assets in divorce, and this imperfect knowledge is correlated with non-coordination. Thus, this paper provides evidence that in a real-world, high-stakes setting, households often behave inefficiently. This suggests there is greater scope for economic models that explicitly incorporate non-cooperative behavior in the study of households' decision-making. To read more on this topic, you can check out the paper's references to other related work. This includes papers on intra-household decision-making, including empirical tests of efficiency, and research on suboptimal financial behavior.